Killer whales are without question one of the most universally recognized and respected species. I think this is partly due to them being one of the world's most powerful predators, that they're like the Tyrannosaurus Rex of the ocean. And I also think it's because many of us see ourselves in killer whales. They're smart, they're social, and they've got strong family bonds. In fact, the more I've been studying them, the more parallels I see between killer whales and people. In my home province on the Pacific coast of Canada, we have three types of killer whales that look physically similar, but are as different as vegetarians and meat lovers. One of the three ecotypes appears to specialize in eating sharks, while a second only eats small marine mammals, and a third specializes in eating fish, particularly large salmon. Each of these ecotypes also has a different dialect and behaviors, and they're culturally distinct, much like different ethnic groups of people. Now, the ecotype I've gotten to know the best are the fish-eating killer whales, shown in this aerial photograph. They're known as resident killer whales because they predictably show up each year as the salmon are migrating back to the natal rivers to spawn and die. Almost all the killer whales in British Columbia have been photographed and named and put into family trees. Knowing who is who for killer whale specialists is as simple as being able to recognize the shape of their dorsal fins, the shape of their gray saddle patches, and their nicks and scars, each which is as distinctive as the fingerprints on your hands. One of the easiest ways to tell adult males and females apart is by the differences in their sizes. Adult males are so much larger than females and have a much taller and bigger dorsal fin. And another curious thing about males is their devotions to their mothers. You see, if you're born a male, you'll stay with your mother for your entire life. But if you're a female, you'll eventually leave your mother when you have your own calves and are ready to lead your own pod. So while males don't actually have tattoos, they're definitely mama's boys. You see, mothers are the heart of the pod. Pods are maternally led. Mothers lead their pods and make all the big decisions on where and when to grow. I think part of our fascination with killer whales is the ease with which we can encounter and observe them, as well as their occasional interest in observing us, such as a spy hopping individual. However, for the most part, killer whales pay us little attention and just want to get on with their daily activities as they travel, rest, socialize, and feed, which they must increasingly do in an environment that has changed dramatically over the past 100 years. You see, the ocean that they once knew has gotten noisier, it's gotten more polluted, and it's being fished harder and harder. A particular concern for resident killer whales is whether or not they're getting enough to eat, which is why I've been leading this project for the past 2 years with a team of researchers that are tracking salmon, analyzing the movements of killer whales, and assessing the availability of salmon for killer whales. In fact, this is the research vessel we've used for the past 2 years to follow whales as they're feeding and looking for fish. On board the ship, we've got listening devices to listen for the whales, and we've also got transducers to send out sound to the seafloor and to bounce off the bladders of fish so we can image them here on our computer screens. We're effectively using the same technique as killer whales use echolocation to find fish, except the killer whales do it much better than people can. And we've also been using other technologies to see as best we can below the water to figure out what's going on, such as drones that we can launch to fly high over top and record, as well as putting on orca cams. These suction cup cameras can be put on to pod members. And for the first time, it's allowed us to see and experience what the killer whales are seeing when they're below the surface outside of our vision. These advanced biologgers are like Fitbits for killer whales. They record movements, times, depths, water temperature, and sound, and they float free from the whale after a preset time. At which point, we can download the videos and watch what it is that the killer whales experienced, how they look for food. Now, the first time I sat and watched the video, I was just struck by the fact that it was like I was seeing killer whales for the first time in a way that I'd never previously known them. Because for all my research career, this is how I've been seeing killer whales, essentially as dorsal fins in front of other dorsal fins and silhouetted an animal swimming more or less in parallel, dorsal fins up, blowhole up, and swimming in a very organized way. And yet, as I watched the videos and watched hours and hours and hours, I realized that things aren't always what they appear. In fact, at one point, I felt like I was watching a Gary Larson cartoon where one of the cows yells out car to warn the others of an approaching automobile, at which point the people get to see the cows in a way that I and others have always known them to be. But they never get to see the other side of cow lives. And so I felt in many ways that my pictures I've been taking killer whales were very much like the center panel, that I was just seeing one aspect of their lives, when in fact there's a lot more going on that we've just not been aware of because we've not been able to record it or see it in its proper way. So what is it that we've been missing? What have the drones and Orca cam recorded that we've not been seeing from our boats as we've sailed along parallel or behind the whales? I'm gonna give you from that same shot here, here's what's going on from above. And you can just see how close the whales are traveling to one another and how they're coming into contact with each other as well as they swim. And particularly young animals that are often drafting under their mothers. So what do you see if you go on to, there are two cameras in this image here, and what are they recording underwater? Well, here for the first time, you can ride along with the pod. Now you probably noticed the tailing edge of the whale's tail as it rubbed across the skin. You saw the dead skin come off as they came into contact with each other. You might have also noticed just how different the skin of a killer whale looks underwater compared to the way we see it when they're above water, looking so shiny and black. You may have also noticed just how green and almost devoid of detail it is under the water compared to this rich landscape that we see each time the whales surface. But of course, killer whales rarely look at what's above the water. In fact, what's struck me most about watching so many hours and hours of Orca cam video is just how dark their world is. And also how, on one level, it seems almost like it's visually impoverished compared to the one that you and I live in. Now, this next video helps to make this point while also pointing out the importance of sound as a way to connect in this very dark, dark world. Have a watch and listen. Orca cameras capture just so many amazing killer whale moments that I think few of us could have imagined. And one of the ones that stands out for me in particular was this moment here where our Orca cam videographer captures a mom with her calf, and watch as the calf comes in to get its belly rubbed. It sort of feels, I watched this, that we just saw a moment just before one of the whales yelled out, "Boat," as they came up to surface. Now, I'd like to leave you with one last final clip from the air that shows some of these strong bonds, this importance of touch, as well as this playfulness of mothers and their offspring. And here we can see three moms with their young ones. Some are turning on their sides and drafting underneath. And then this next one, this young one here has got a piece of fish in its mouth. And mom's coming in here to give a little rub. And finally, what could be more satisfying for a youngster than to whack its mother's head with its tail as mom playfully pushes the calf along. So I hope that watching these videos has also made you realize, as much as I have, just how much we have in common with killer whales. Just like us, they thrive on being touched and on connecting with others through touch. Touching is undoubtedly key to keeping their pods healthy and together. For me, one of the hardest things about COVID has been not being able to touch others and the ones we love. And I think we all have a great appreciation of the power of touch, the need for touch, and its ability to keep us connected and healthy, just like the killer whales. Thank you.